The Basel II Accord, issued by the Bank for International Settlements in the Swiss city of Basel, has been partly replaced by Basel III and other regulations. However, many years after its release in 2004, various regulators across the world still refer to this accord as a standard. As its name suggests, the International Convergence of Capital Measurement and Capital Standards Framework aims at a level bank capital requirement playing field for banks around the globe. The treaty is built on three pillars. 1. Minimal capital requirements to ensure that all banks would follow the same rules and definitions. 2. Supervisory review to make sure the various central banks would work in the same manner, and 3. Disclosure as a lever to strengthen sound banking practices through market discipline. The first pillar, the minimum capital requirements, is the most important. The Basel Accord requires banks to maintain capital buffers for three types of risk: credit risk, market risk, and operational risk. For nearly all banks, credit risk will require the most capital. The size of the market risk will depend on how active the bank is on the financial markets and how much of its balance sheet is exposed to market price movements. Operational risk tends to come last in terms of risk exposure. The treaty defines operational risk as the risk of loss resulting from inadequate or failed internal processes, people, and systems or from external events. The definition includes legal risk but does not include strategic and reputational risks. Operational risk occurs in the day-to-day activities of the bank. It could be as simple as accepting a fake check, making a mistake in a loan contract, or buggy software that makes incorrect interest calculations. There is a wide range of possible sources of operational risk, and the actual impact of these risks may vary widely. Moreover, many risks occur infrequently, which makes it difficult to collect statistical data. Gauging operational risk is difficult. Basel II provides three methods to assess operational risks and the corresponding capital needs. The basic indicator approach, standardized approach, and advanced measurement approaches. The approaches are ranked by an increasing degree of sophistication. The advanced measurement approach is therefore the most elaborate. Here, the bank itself develops a method to assess its operational risk and underpins this approach with statistical data and mathematical modeling. This approach requires much interaction with and approval from the local regulator. Since this method is always bespoke, we will skip the advanced measurement approach in this video. We will start with the basic indicator approach. This approach is straightforward and only considers the bank's gross income. The gross income consists of the net interest income plus net non-interest income. The income should be the gross of provisions, operating expenses, profits, and losses of securities, and exclude extraordinary items. This gross income is a proxy for the size of the operational risk. We do understand that this is a rough estimate. The gross income is averaged over the last 3 years. If any year produces a loss, that year is excluded from the calculation altogether. We arrive at the capital charge for operational risk by multiplying by a factor called alpha. This factor is determined by the Basel Committee and was originally set at 15%. Let's turn to an Excel example to get a better understanding. We have the gross income numbers for this financial institution for 3 years, 160, minus 790, and 320. Since there is a loss for the second year, this number is excluded from the calculation. We are left with the gross income for the first and third years. The average income for these 2 years is 240. The capital charge is 15%, which gives us 36. As we said earlier, this is indeed a basic approach. The standardized has a bit more depth as it considers 3 year gross income split up per business line. The Basel II Accord lists 8 business lines. 1. Corporate finance. 2. Trading and sales. 3. Retail banking. 4. Commercial banking. 5. Payment and settlement. 6. Agency services. 7. Asset management, and 8. Retail brokerage. In the annex to the treaty, the business lines are described in more detail. Instead of having a global factor alpha for the bank, in the standardized approach we use a factor that differs per business line. These factors are called betas. The betas are set by Basel. The standardized approach also treats years with an operational loss differently. Instead of excluding the losses from the calculation, these years are included at zero value in the calculation of the three-year average. Again, an Excel example is helpful here. We calculate the capital charge per business line per year. Positive and negative numbers may be offset across the year. However, when the sum of the charges is negative for a particular year, we replace the negative amount with zero. The Excel function max is helpful here. This value picks the greater of the values, the year's capital charge or zero. Applying these rules gets us a capital charge of 24. The difference with the basic indicator approach, where we had a capital charge of 36, can be explained by the more favorable treatment of losses in the standardized approach. We point out that the capital charges calculated here are not the final capital charges under Basel II. They represent an intermediate step in the capital calculation. They are added to the capital charges for the other risk groups, credit risk and market risk. The capital charge for the bank is a percentage against this sum and was set at 8% originally. So, the 36 and 24 found for our basic indicator and standardized approach would, at this 8% rate, lead to an actual capital claim of 2.88 and 1.92, respectively. For smaller financial institutions wishing to reduce their regulatory capital charges, it might still be useful to upgrade to the standardized approach. We already noticed the favorable treatment of losses. Furthermore, smaller banks might have fewer business lines. For the simplest financial institutions, this could be just retail banking. The other business lines are absent and do not generate income. This would mean that the 12% beta for retail banking applies to the entire gross income. Effectively, this results in a drop of the capital charge from an alpha of 15% under the basic indicator approach to just 12% under the standardized approach. Thanks for watching and good luck.